Red Wings Live is presented by Spartan Stores. For locations, visit turntospartan.com.
Stamkos went back that way. Glendening got to it. Chipped the pass. There's a race now. Glendening catching up to it. Glendening right in. Spinorama play. Back. Oh. Scores! Oh my goodness.
Wow.
There's a beautiful backhand goal from Luke Glendening. And it's a shorthanded goal. And the Red Wings have a two-goal lead. Johnson and Glendening as it's kicked back here to the line to Hedman. Shot is blocked.
Oh,
getting
my
in
God,
front of Glendening. And he clears it up to center ice. As Hedman's got it at center. Back in for Tampa Bay. Clock runs out, and the Detroit Red Wings have taken away home ice advantage from the number one home team in the National Hockey League.
Ah, the shorty of Biggie, and it all adds up to a 1-0 series lead for the Wings. Welcome to the special playoff post-game edition of Red Wings Live with Chris Osgood and Darren Elliott. I'm Mickey York. Happy to be with you following Game 1 of the Wings' best-of-7 opening round series with the Tampa Bay Lightning. Game 1 goes to the Wings, 3-2 the final. The best team on home ice during the regular season loses it one game into this postseason.
That's how quickly things can change. All of a sudden, the proverbial you stole home ice away from the team that's the best home ice team. Well, that was the regular season. We saw a lot of differences. Playoff hockey, great goaltending by Peter Mrazek, and maybe not so much at the other end.
Detroit came in here really trying to slow down the Tampa Bay Lightning. Did not do that. They're flying through the neutral zone. They're going to have to obviously correct that. Glendening, second best player on the ice tonight besides Mrazek. Unbelievable play at the end. To me, that's the play of the game, a block shot, then the presence of mind to kick it out into the neutral zone to preserve the win. But really, the Red Wings battled, like Henrik Zetterberg said, for the full 60. And they had to battle in their own zone because they were in their zone most of that game.
It feels like you're battling when you're chasing the puck all night, and they chased the puck all night long.
Yeah, things to improve on yet at the end of the night. You're up one zip. If you want to say the Wings stole game one, that's fine. That's the Wings would prefer to say they took it. Back in Tampa, the captain is with Trevor Thompson.
Mickey, the first thing I said to the captain when he walked in the room was, wow, under siege all night long, you still come out winners here in game one. How?
Oh, well, we battled for 60 minutes. PK was really good today. Took a little bit too many penalties, gave him a lot of momentum. Peter Mrazek, unbelievable in goal, and you know, we got the first one.
When you're outshot 46-14 and you take 7 penalties, you really don't think it's going to go your way. How much of an influence did Peter Mrazek have on this game from your point of view?
He was solid. You know, we felt from the start that he was on his game. Obviously, when we got that third one by Glendening, it was nice to get two goals lead, but then they almost tied it up there and then, but we find a way.
You had never played these guys in the playoffs before. There wasn't much acrimony between the two teams in the regular season. Do you think there was enough out there? I saw a little chippiness near the end. Obviously, you took game one. Do you think that's going to raise the level of the series now?
Well, I think the more you play against them, the longer the series goes, the more chipper we'll get. But it was, you know, we got to be better than we were today. But we got the W, and that's what it's all about.
How big of a boost is this for your team right now, Henrik?
It's nice. It's nice to get a good start in the series. It's 1-4. Obviously, we got one here tonight. We got to regroup here tomorrow and be ready.
What will be the keys for your team moving on now?
Just get energized again. Have a solid day tomorrow. Work on the stuff that wasn't good today and just be ready to go.
Congrats on a big win here in game one, and good luck the rest of the way, Henrik.
Thanks, Rob.
There's Henrik Zetterberg. He and the Red Wings escaping game one, 3-2 winners. Now back to you inside the studio.
All right. They will leave Tampa with what they came for, at least one win in their building, hoping to get greedy on Saturday with a win in game two. And, guys, let's just begin with the goaltender. I know that's right in your wheelhouse. Peter Mrazek makes 44 saves in his playoff debut, a modern-day Red Wings playoff record. He was the busiest dude in the building.
Well, one thing straight. First and foremost, you'll take wins any way you can get them in the playoffs. And although they were under siege, they had a lot of guys that sacrificed a lot in their own zone to make sure it didn't get in the net. Other than Peter Mrazek, he obviously was the first star of this game. But it's all about the race to four, and that's what Henrik Zetterberg's right about. Take any type of win you can get, and Mrazek was fabulous. And I thought really from the onset of this game, he looked calm, cool. He wasn't overplaying anything. Third period got caught out a few times, but really a quick study. Then he started to play the puck quicker. But really, from the drop of this puck, this kid looked on his game just like he did in Carolina, Darren.
Yeah, he had real quiet feet on his original setup. And the one thing that gets, I think, overlooked because he is just 23, he reads the play. So he has hockey sense. Yes, goalies can have hockey sense. His early reads and then his reaction afterwards. Yeah, he likes to put a little mustard on some of the plays. That's okay as well. But I just like when his early setup has him with the quiet feet, I know he's going to be
in good position to make saves, and he made an awful lot of them tonight.
And some of those big rebounds we saw him give up during the regular season, those weren't there so much tonight.
No, sometimes when he punches the puck, it's on purpose. Mickey had it in the pregame show in the original telecast. It's like you're trying to get it to your winger. You're trying to kick it past the traffic. So sometimes those rebounds are by design. There are things where we'd like to see him catch the puck a little more sometimes because he can control the tempo better.
And that's some coming of age. You don't learn by just practicing exclusively. And he's been in enough games now where now he feels comfortable, and you can tell each and every game he's gotten better at his rebound control, especially in traffic. I thought he was really, really good tonight in traffic. He made a huge save at the end. There was four or five guys in front of him. He hit his right pad. He really tracked it well tonight through traffic. Everybody said he's small. He doesn't look that well. He played really big tonight. The kid, he's 6'1", and when he's on his skates, probably close to 6'3", but he played big tonight out of the blue and really frustrated Tampa.
Mrazek's play obviously stood out. So did the play of the Wings penalty kill and Luke Glendening, which we believe were sort of one and the same.
Very much so. And Ozzie made the point on the, you know, last, you're trying to win the game, you lose the faceoff cleanly, but Glendening didn't panic, gets in the shooting lane, blocks the shot, loses his stick, and kicks it to the neutral zone. But here we go on the goal on the penalty kill. First stick in lane, perfect positioning, and then tracks it down after that. It was 101 feet. He knows everybody else is changing behind him. Now he starts making decisions.
Yeah, and he's a tired man right here. He's been thinking about shooting this, but if he misses the net, this thing comes around. Tampa Bay's off to the race the other way. Maybe took a peek and saw it was Phil Pula as the defender. Just a quick wraparound. Just trying to get this thing on the net. Ends up going through Gentle Ben, who was a little bit sleepy in the net tonight. But really now, they've got him on the ropes, too. Yeah. This goalie, he's never won a playoff game. They're 0-5 in their last five playoff games, Tampa Bay Lightning. If Detroit comes after him in the first period next game, he might not last next game.
Yeah, that's one thing that there still is out there. You haven't had a barrage on Ben Bishop. You already have a win in the win column, but you haven't really put it on him yet.
But Ozzie, as you pointed out early tonight, you thought Bishop looked shaky in net, so hey, just get a puck on net, maybe something happens, and Glendening made it happen.
I would say this, Mrazek had the swagger, Bishop didn't have any swagger tonight, really, and you could tell his mannerisms, his body language, he didn't look like he was engaged in the game where Mrazek did. He was out, he's out of the blue. He looked like he was a confident goaltender. And your players draw off that. They notice that. They can see that. And Bishop, a few times, even playing the puck, his guy was in the right spot and kind of gave the head shake. Your guys know that. They notice stuff like that. So I think if Detroit really goes after him, makes it harder on him next game, they're going to be able to get some pucks by him again.
Yeah, there's swagger and there's wobble. And one guy was wobbly. And it is hard when you don't get much action. But body language goes a long way to doing that. And as Ozzie talked about, making good decisions with the puck, any way to show your teammates that you're engaged even though you're not getting a lot of shots, he didn't do that. And when he had to make a few saves, he didn't make them.
And the screws get a little tighter when you're down one zip.
Especially when you lose that first game at home. I mean, that makes it difficult, makes it much, much better for the Red Wings.
Especially for him. I mean, he's played one playoff game, he lost. He's 0-1. Now it's not a must win, but in their minds and that locker room, it will be for Tampa Bay. It's going to be a ton of pressure next game at home for him.
All right, Luke Glendening, shorthanded goal, the game winner. The other two goals scored by Pavel Datsyuk, who was sensational tonight.
Pavel Datsyuk, especially through 40 minutes, the last period they were holding on, but through 40 minutes, if there was offense with the Red Wings, Pavel Datsyuk was on the ice. And this one was a nice play by Kyle Quincy. We don't see many shots coming through from the blue line, but look at this deft deflection. The goalie blade. Kenny and Mick talk about that big paddle that Pavel Datsyuk uses.
That stick blade of his is almost illegal. It's so big, it almost comes off an old goalie stick. But this is what he's good at, is changing the angle of his shot here. Brings it out wide and sizzles one into the top of the net. And this came quick in the second period, really catching the Tampa Bay Lightning off guard. But Pavel Datsyuk was their best player for two periods. And there was a lot of guys that played great for the Red Wings. They did a lot of great plays, little plays around the net. I thought Kyle Quincy played great tonight. I thought Miller was good up front tonight as well. A lot of guys, I can go on and on, but a win's a win no matter how badly you get shot, they'll take it.
When you play in your own zone, I liked Erickson's game. I liked DeKaiser's game. And so when you play in your own zone, it's good to be, you know, mentioning defensemen because they were under siege an awful lot, just like the goaltender.
Marchenko was good, too, as well. Yeah. He had some big hits. It's nice to see that physical activity coming back from that blue line. I thought they battled. Their battle level was high. They scratched and clawed for that win today.
All right, we're just getting started with our Game 1 post-game coverage as we scratch and claw our way through the next hour. When we come back, we'll show you all the Game 1 highlights. Plenty more still to come from Tampa, including all the post-game reactions in the dressing room. A conversation with that man, Peter Mrazek, on the way when Red Wings Live rolls on. Well, virtually everyone is picking the Lightning to win this series, and those that do will point to these several statistical advantages Tampa Bay has over Detroit. But one area that's a major plus for the Wings is experience. At the start of the night, they possessed a combined 1,011 games of playoff experience, third most in these playoffs behind the Blackhawks and the Penguins. The Lightning are 11th with just 545 combined playoff games. The goalies, however, were dead even in that category. Both netminders making their NHL playoff debuts tonight. The first guy to experience a postseason win, Peter Mrazek. Back in Tampa, Trevor Thompson has caught up with him in the dressing room. This interview is brought to you by Menards, saving money on all your home improvement needs at Menards.
Obviously, that was a busy night for you. How do you describe it?
Busy from the beginning. You know, we knew it's first 10 minutes going to be huge for us. We scored first. That was huge in the first period.
When did you know you were on your game? At what point in the game did you really feel it for yourself? Because you seem to be in a zone here tonight.
You know, when they shoot from everywhere in first period, I had, I think, 10 or 11 shots. That helps you in a game. And, you know, in second, I had 17, so that helps you keep in a game all the time.
Obviously. You know, on the second goal, on Boyle's goal, did you kind of second-guess challenging him, or?
You mean the first one, right?
Yeah, sorry, the first one.
Yeah, I thought he was going to go backhand, five hole. You know, he stopped it, put it to the empty net. I lost the puck when they chipped out from their zone, and I should go out there and skate for it and play puck out.
Peter, just talk about early on in the game, you had to make several big saves early when they were pressuring you. How much did that help get you in the game early, facing a lot of shots?
It always helps you in the first 5 minutes. They shoot from everywhere, and, you know, it hits you. So it's a huge part of the game that they didn't score in the first 5 minutes.
It seemed like goalie interference calls on you. They were trying to...
You know, they're going to the net hard. So if I'm on the blue paint, I know they're going to come and they're going to try to bump me or hit me. So I was ready for that.
How fun was playing that game tonight with that crowd and everything in the playoffs?
So fun. It was, big, huge crowd It's huge that for us that we have the first win.
How about just Powell's game, two goals tonight?
Huge, you know, for us. When in our power play, the second goal was really nice. The first tip too, so, you know, he's key for us in these games.
Peter, obviously the team took a lot of penalties tonight too, and the penalty kill unit had to be strong. Yeah. Just from that perspective, how much stress was on your penalty killing unit and you tonight from that
angle? You know, it's fun to have the penalty kill, but it was a huge part for us. We knew they have a good power play. Stamkos on the point, you know, they run it really well. So, guys block so many shots from me there.
And Peter Mrazek, as you might have guessed, is tonight's Fox Sports Detroit Red Wings Player of the Game, as presented by the $2 for $5 Classic Quarter Pounder with cheese. The second most saves in a playoff debut since the 05-06 season when Roberto Luongo stopped 72 of them. That had to have included a couple of extra periods of hockey in that one. Mrazek's performance also tonight puts him in the Red Wings record books, guys. Look at the company he joins with those 44 saves in his playoff debut tonight.
Quarter pounder worthy if I ever saw, and that's the list as well. Roy Edwards, one of my favorites as a kid growing up.
I can't say I saw Roy Edwards play, but I saw Tim Chevalier. I haven't saw Gustafson play too much this year, and I saw a lot of Jimmy Howard, but congratulations to Mrazek. Absolutely a fabulous game by that young goaltender.
All right, much more from Tampa Bay is still to come here on our Red Wings Live playoff postgame coverage. We'll take you back to Tampa. Trevor Thompson will go one-on-one with the head coach, Mike Babcock's thoughts after the Wings take a 1-0 series lead over the Lightning after tonight's 3-2 win. Tonight's high-speed highlights brought to you by Xfinity. Peter Mrazek and Ben Bishop making their playoff debuts in Game 1. Who would blink first? It took the Wings over 90 minutes just to get their first shot on goal in this game, but it was a good one. Kyle Quincy from the point, through traffic, waits for Pavel Datsyuk to get out front. Pav gets the blade down and redirects it past Bishop to give the Wings a 1-0 lead. Nifty work by the magician. Wings then go on the power play looking for a 2-0 lead, but they turn it over, and Brian Boyle breaks in all alone on Peter Mrazek. Puck in the net, game tied at 1 on the Lightning shorthanded goal. Now the Lightning go on the power play, and the Wings try to cash in on a shorty of their own. Drew Miller in on Ben Bishop, but Bishop able to knock that aside to keep the game tied at 1 after 1. To the second, the Wings take the lead. In fact, they do it just 8 seconds into the period. Off the draw, Helm chases the puck down, gets the Pavel Datsyuk, makes a nifty move out in front to beat Bishop top shelf.
his sixth career multi-goal playoff game. Pavel Datsyuk 2, Lightning 1. Lightning, though, looking for the equalizer. Nikita Kucherov with a perfect pass to Braden Colbert. Oh, Peter Mrazek will take that. Thank you. One of many fine saves for the rookie tender tonight. To the third, Lightning on the power play. Luke Glendening makes a great play to chip it out of his own end, then collects the puck. Doesn't look like much is going to come out of this, but then goes to the back. Oh, the backhand lethal for Luke Glendening. We've said it multiple times this season. His second career playoff goal in just six games makes it 3-1 Wings, but the Lightning not going down without a fight. Alex Killorn with the shot that rings the crossbar, but the Lightning corral it, and eventually it finds its way to Nikita Nesterov's stick. He will sneak it in past Peter Mrazek to make it a one-goal game at 3-2. All right, Tampa still swarming the Wings net late. Matt Carl rips one of Mrazek, but he gets a piece of it as he's leaning the other way. I thought this was a really good save, Ozzy.
Unbelievable. It comes out again out of the blue. Really aggressive, catching that Tampa Bay player off guard.
All right, one last chance for Tampa Bay, but look at Glendening there, able to get a skate on the puck to kick it out of the wing zone, and time will expire as the Wings get away with a game one win, 1-0 to final. And guys, as you look at the numbers tonight, it was lopsided in favor of Tampa Bay in most of the statistical categories, but the final score is all that matters as we present tonight's game summary brought to you by the Motor City Casino and Hotel.
0-7, penalty kill, we've talked about it already. That just stands out. That's why the shot disparity was what it was. Great battle by guys in front of Mrazek.
I'm going to go completely off this board. A guy never gets enough respect, a defenseman. For your Red Wings, Nicholas Cromwell played 25-34 with three block shots. Unbelievable game. Under the radar, again, this guy is an awesome player.
And the bottom line is, in Tampa tonight, the Wings emerged from game one of their playoff series with the Lightning with a 1-0 lead. During their last 24 playoff season, the Wings are 25-7 in series in which they win game one. This series, of course, will no doubt take several twists and turns before it's settled. That is the nature of playoff hockey. Mike Babcock, now with 80 playoff wins to his credit, two away from tying Tobe Blake for ninth all-time. He, of course, knows the twists and turns of the postseason better than most. Here are his thoughts on the Wings' game one win as we send it back to Tampa and Trevor Thompson.
Well, the Red Wings couldn't get out of their end for a lot of this game here tonight. We're outshot 46-14, yet they come away 3-2 winners in game one. Mike, when you reflect on tonight's game, what sticks out most to you?
Well, obviously good goaltending, real good box outs, good penalty killing. I thought Pavel, Helm, that group there was on it, was real good. I thought Glennie's line was real good. Our D battle hard. We didn't have enough forwards going, didn't execute on the walls to come out of our zone very good, and had it on the wall too much. So we're going to have to fix that. I don't see that as being a big problem, but we came in here to get a win. We got a win, and now we got to regroup here tomorrow and get on track and play the way we're capable of playing.
As you were struggling to get out of your own end for a lot of that third period, what was your message to the team? Because obviously that does expend a lot of energy trying to get out of your own end and kill those penalties.
Well,
like
no
that.
Question. I mean, we took seven minors, so that's way too many. And anytime you take seven minors, I mean, that's a chunk of the game. If you're a guy who doesn't penalty kill, I mean, there's not much of the game left for you. So when you go through that, you know, that was a problem for us. And then, you know, up front, we didn't have enough guys going. So we'll enjoy the win here tonight, and we'll get ready for the next one tomorrow, and we'll have a good practice and get everyone skating, because we can skate way better, manage the puck way better, and play better than we did tonight.
Give me a deeper thought on Peter Mrazek and the way that he performed. It seemed like his confidence just built and built as the game went on.
Well, obviously, he did a real good job. I mean, he was there, he was square, he played the puck well, he stopped the puck well, and you know, it's kind of what we've come to expect from him. We think he's a real good goaltender, and he's got lots of confidence.
Any changes coming ahead for Saturday's game?
Yeah, well, I mean, lots of changes in the way we play, but I mean, the great thing about we'll watch the game and figure it out.
Congrats, Mike.
Thank you.
There's Mike Babcock. He leaves game one here in Tampa a winner. We'll see what happens in game two as we move on in this series. Now back to you inside the studio.
And he heads off into the night knowing the Wings can play better, yet satisfied with the fact that they have a 1-0 series lead. Mike Wolf from Tampa Bay still to come. Up next, we'll check back in with Ken Daniels and Mickey Redman for tonight's Bleach Report. This playoff edition of Red Wings Live is brought to you by Spartan Stores. For locations, visit turntospartan.com. And by Miller Lights, back in its original look, it's Miller time.
Stamkos went back that way. Glendening got to it, chipped the pass. There's a race now. Glendening catching up to it. Glendening right in. Spinorama play, back, and it's gone!
scores!
Oh, my God. Wow.
There's a beautiful backhand goal from Luke Glendening, and it's a shorthanded goal, and the Red Wings have a two-goal lead.
What would you expect from him?
Not
but
that,
another backhander.
But a backhand, yes.
It didn't look like it was going to turn into anything. It turned into a 1-0 series lead for the Wings. Tampa Bay Lightning, by the way, posted the best home record in the NHL during the regular season, setting a franchise record with 32 home wins, a record that included a 14-4-1 mark against teams currently in the playoffs. The Wings came up empty in their two trips to Tampa Bay this season. In fact, they hadn't won a game in Tampa since February of 2011. Words they'd love to hear in California right now. The drought is over. Here's Kenna Mick with more on Game 1 in tonight's Booth Report.
Well, the Red Wings off on the right skate, just like a year ago against Boston, and just like a year ago was Pavel Datsyuk, but much earlier than waiting near the end of the game to win it 1-0, but equally great Datsyuk here tonight.
Well, there were a lot of great performances here tonight. Obviously, Mrazek with all those shots and the great saves, and Glendening with his penalty killing and the shorthanded goal. But I thought the guys that set the pace early in this hockey game, being outshot badly, were 43-13. That's Darren Helm. And you've got two assists on both the Datsyuk goals. But, I mean, Darren Helm started back in 2008 against the Pittsburgh Penguins, scored two goals in the finals, and he was a rookie coming out of Grand Rapids, for goodness sake. He's now, you know, 7 years later, a veteran player coming into his own, had a good goal scoring here this year. In the last 2 years, he's been injured more than he's played. And, boy, oh, boy, he has really become a catalyst for this Detroit Red Wing team. And he's been rewarded playing with Datsyuk and Zetterberg a lot. And, obviously, that's working. So, Pavel had the magic touch, Ken, around the net. But Darren Helm, penalty killing like Glendening and what have you. His great speed again. He is the roadrunner, and this guy is a key contributor for Mike Babcock and the Detroit Red Wings here in the 2015 playoffs.
Bottom line is, though, when you're going into Game 2 here in a couple of days, you cannot take seven penalties.
Oh, God, no.
Tampa Bay.
No, they got a lot to clean up, and I'm sure you're gonna. They're going, oh boy, are we lucky to get out of this baby? They got outplayed badly. They got outshot badly. Other than that, they took advantage. They really boxed out a lot well. They didn't give them a lot of speed, except for the third period. I mean, they were paying the price, but they've got to generate more and not be collapsing so far back, and not depend on their goaltender, not depend on their penalty killing, because you can't go to that well that often. It's just not going to happen, and this team's too good. They will eventually score. So, conversations the next 2 days. Boys, we got to be a lot better. And Zetterberg will lead the pack. He'll tell you that, and he'll rally the troops to have a much better effort here on Saturday afternoon.
So there's no conversation, you think, about who's starting in goal? Never mind.
We're done.
Cut it out, Daniels. Quit trying to stir the pot. All right, when we come back, we'll reset the Game 1 action for you, take you back to Tampa Bay for more post-game interviews, including a conversation with that guy, Luke Glendening, as the Wings take Game 1 over the Lightning. Checking in, the Wings stole a home ice advantage from the Lightning tonight. Luke Glendening scored what turned out to be the game-winning goal, a beauty of a backhanded, shorthanded goal. Peter Mrazek outstanding tonight in his first ever playoff game, stopping 44 shots as the Wings surprised the Lightning with a 3-2 Game 1 win. Welcome back to our Red Wings Live playoff post-game coverage. Chris Osgood, Darren Elliott, and Mickey York continuing to break down the Wings' Game 1 win. We talked about Peter Mrazek, what he did tonight in his playoff debut. He wasn't the only Red Wing experiencing his first postseason action tonight, and the kids did well for themselves.
They most certainly did. I thought young Ferraro played very well. I thought at the end, when the goaltender was pulled, he had an opportunity to score. It went in the corner. He did a great job to kill some more time. Great clock awareness and situation awareness by a young player. I thought Marchenko banged back almost 18 minutes on defense, was very good. He's physical back there. I thought all these young players played very well. Glendening played great as well. Obviously, he's not as young as the other guys, but I also thought Danny DeKeyser almost played 20 minutes. Very solid back there with five hits.
Young players, especially the guys playing in defensive roles, and he just mentioned just about all of them.
Yep.
Because you're in your zone so much, they had to play well, and they did. A lot of battle, a lot of tough minutes out there, and they handle it very well.
Yeah, Glendening, not his first playoff go around, but he'd probably tell you this was his biggest playoff goal so far, the second of his career. And as we send you back to Tampa Bay, Trevor Thompson is talking with him.
I mean, it was a pretty fortunate, I think it went five hole or something. I'm not sure. I don't even think it hit the back of the net. But to try to get on net, I guess I was
kind of lucky break
yeah.
there.
that's your preferred go-to move now, isn't it, your backhand?
I guess it's been working more than my forehand, but, I'll take what I can get.
Scoring shorthanded in a playoff to give you guys a victory on the road, does it get much better?
It's exciting for our team to get a big win. We didn't play our best tonight, but to get a win is big.
Let's talk about Peter's game.
Which one?
Start with Peter's game.
He was unbelievable tonight. Kept us in the game. I think he had 42 shots or something like that against him. To play the way he did, it was unbelievable.
How big two goals from him? Never gets old watching him,
does. Yeah, he's phenomenal to watch, unbelievable talent, and to have him on our team's a huge bonus.
You guys' work at the penalty kill too, Glenn. Stopped them all seven chances. What was the difference there?
Yeah, I think it was just our work ethic. From the outset we were committed to getting the pucks and trying to block shots, and obviously your best penalty killer has to be your goalie, and Mrazek was great tonight.
When you get outshot as bad as you guys did, how do you just limit
limit the penalties or shots? We got it's stick work. We got to keep our sticks down. That's what we got called for a lot tonight, and it's something we got to work on for sure.
From Luke Glendening, we bring you Luke Glendening. Tonight's Total Impact brought to you by Total Hockey. His shorthanded goal early in the third period after forcing a turnover at the collective to put up a spin around on the back end to beat Ben Bishop. That ends up being the game-winning goal as the Wings win it 3-2, and perhaps a new nickname has been coined for him. Backhand Luke is what the word is on the streets these days. All right, post-game reaction from game one continues to roll in from Tampa Bay. We'll take you back to the dressing room where Trevor Thompson will catch up with Darren Helm. That and more when we return. This playoff edition of Red Wings Live is brought to you by Menards. Save big money on all your home improvement needs at Menards. Elsewhere around the league tonight, the Penguins and Rangers got their series underway at the Garden. And just 28 seconds into the game, a goal found the nets. Rangers strike first. Rick Nash shot bounces off Marc-Andre Fleury. Derek Brassard there for the rebound. And just like that, 1-0 New York. Later in the period, Rangers go on the power play. Keith Yandle to Ryan McDonough. He'll fire from just inside the blue line, and the Rangers take a 2-0 lead. In the second, Pittsburgh trying to get back in it, and they do here when Ben Lovejoy fires on Henrik Lundqvist, but Blake Como is there for the rebound. Penguins on the board, but that's all they get tonight. Rangers hold on to take game one by a final of 2-1. 3-2 the final from game one of the Wings' best of seven first round playoff series with Tampa Bay. The first ever postseason meeting between these two teams. And guys, Pavel Datsyuk, as we saw, scored their first two goals tonight. The second, however, was set up by just an all-out hustle effort by Darren Helm.
Yeah, absolutely, and I wasn't sure if that was a set play or not. Darren, we talked about off the center ice draw at the beginning of that period, if Datsyuk chipped it through and Helm using his speed got to him. I'm most impressed with it. You can tell he's confident because he's got his head up. He used to just skate fast without the head up. Here he is to the races here, but he gets his head up here. He turns, checks out where everybody is, heads up play by him, might go to the point, Zdlicky decides, hey, Pavel Datsyuk heading through the slot. Why not give it to him? Why not? And he does just that, Darren.
And Yurko going to the front of the net, opens up that ice, and then the change of the angle, Yurko with the screen, making the 6'7" goaltender look small, and a beautiful shot by Pavel Datsyuk. But Helm in on both goals scored by Pavel Datsyuk. And that was your pick for the X factor.
We got a long ways to go. Yeah, my player of the series, but good start, 2 assists, played over 20 minutes. I thought he played a great game tonight in my top 5 players.
All right, Darren Helm talking about that good start with Trevor Thompson as we take you back inside the Wings dressing room in Tampa Bay.
Inside the locker room with Darren Helm, who picked up an assist on the first goal of the game here tonight. How much of a lift did that first goal give your team, especially on the road to start this series, Darren?
It was a big boost. I think calmed a few of the nerves. It would have been nice if we continued that style of play of getting the puck in, getting pucks to the net, and played in their zone a little bit more. But they came out and they played pretty hard. Peter made some big saves, but it was definitely nice getting that first one to kind of, give us a little bit of a cushion.
What was the difference? Because from the second half of the second period on, it seemed like you were really under siege and really couldn't get out of your own end, especially given all the penalties the team took. What was the difference?
you know, they were just they found ways to you know, cycle, get pucks on net, get second opportunities, and we just couldn't establish a forecheck. I thought we had to puck in their zone a few times, but they came skating right out pretty quick. You know, we didn't do a good enough job playing hard in their zone, being heavy on the puck. That's an area that we definitely need to clean up and be a lot better on. I've said a few times, Peter's not going to bail us out of every game, so we got to pull one out for him.
Your thoughts on the way he did perform here in game one, his first playoff game at this level?
It was great. Won us the game.
As far as coming away from a game where you have seven penalties, give up 46 shots on net, and come away with a win, obviously that doesn't happen often in this league. What are you going to have to do to get a win in game two? Because obviously that might not get it done.
Yeah, exactly. You know, not the style of play that we want, especially in the playoffs. Extremely happy that we found a way to win. But you know, like you said, we're not going to win games like that every night, and definitely down the stretch. So, you know, sustain time in their zone, cycle pucks, be heavy on the puck, get shots in the net, get seconds. You know, we can't be one and done in their zone, letting them skate out every time. We gotta be a little bit harder in the puck, forecheck, and you know, give our D and goalie some rest.
Now that they've tasted defeat in game one of this series, what kind of pushback are you expecting from them in game two?
I expect them to play pretty similar to the way they did tonight, maybe a little bit harder. You know, we saw last year Boston, we had that first one and they came even harder and harder each game. So we can't be satisfied with a win, even though we didn't play well. We got to be hungry for the next one.
One more thought on your line and Pavel Datsyuk, especially the way he performed tonight.
Great as always. Found ways to get stick on the puck, get open. You know, two big goals for us, obviously. And, you know, we need that from him.
Appreciate the time, Darren. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
There's Darren Helm inside the Red Wings locker room. Picks up an assist and a big win in game one here in Tampa. Back to you for now.
All right, Trev, thanks. When we continue, we'll have more from Mike Babcock. We'll also queue up tonight's instant replay. All the best from game one brought to you by the dulcet tones of Ken Daniels and Mickey Redman. Well, if you believe the prognosticators, the Wings weren't supposed to score in this series, take a lead in this series, or win a game in this series. It took them all of one game to do all of those things. All the items checked off their game one to-do list will be highlighted in tonight's instant replay.
It's day two of the 2015 Stanley Cup playoffs. Game one, Tampa and Detroit. First ever playoff meeting. Steve Yzerman's Lightning facing his mentors, Red Wings. Helm goes back to the line here for Quincy. A little fake there, got it through. Scores! Tipped in front of the goal. Pavel Datsyuk gets the goal. And it's 1-0.
First shot on goal for the Red Wings. Nice thought process by Quincy. He waited and waited. He did not want to get that shot blocked, and he found a way to get it through, and it's redirected by the magician.
Jedlinski playing in his 39th career playoff game. Gets checked.
Where's Mrazek? Brian Boyle has three shorthanded goals this year and five on the power play of his 15, and he makes no mistake on this one. A beautiful move by Brian Boyle to tie this game.
This is the fourth consecutive season the Red Wings will start the playoffs on the road after only doing so twice in the previous 20 playoff seasons.
Oh,
scores!
Bingo!
Right off the bat, it's another power play goal.
What a move by Datsyuk, but an even better move by Darren Helm to put him in that position, and the Red Wings regain the lead. Wow. Play out here.
Palat moved it quickly. Oh. Saved by Mrazek. Good stop on Coburn. The defenseman making his return to the lineup. Stamkos went back that way. Glendening got to it. Chipped it past. There's a race now. Glendening catching up to it. Glendening right in. Spinorama play. Backhand. Oh. Scores!
Oh, wow.
There's a beautiful backhand goal from Luke Glendening. And it's a shorthanded goal. And the Red Wings have a two-goal lead.
Edmund gets out-decisioned, and it's all over. And a backhander that squeaks through 6'7", Ben Bishop, and a 3-1 Detroit. Wow.
Horn with a shot rising, and they've got the crossbar. Here's Callahan back to the line. Nesterov again, pulls it back, shoots, scores!
Detroit was gassed after the icing, and then another 45 seconds of being hemmed in, and now we got a one-goal game. Hooking penalty to Detroit's helm, they say. Face-off critical.
Johnson and Glendening as it's kicked back here to line to Hedman. Shot is blocked.
Oh,
getting
my
in
God,
front of
Glendening,
and he clears it up to center ice as Hedman's got it at center. Back in for Tampa Bay. Clock runs out, and the Detroit Red Wings have taken away home ice advantage from the number one home team in the National Hockey League.
44 in 7-for-7, the big numbers that stand out for the Wings tonight, guys.
Yeah, and actually, of the 44, the 42 saves by Peter Mrazek. 13 block shots, that's a lot for Detroit. There are a lot of opportunities to block shots in this one.
Yeah, the penalty kill for the Red Wings, absolutely fabulous. And that little toll at the end, 3 for the Red Wings, 2 for Lane. That's all that matters at this time of the year. Get the W's.
All right, for more on the Game 1 win, we take you to Mike Babcock's post-game press conference back in Tampa.
Well, I thought he played well. I mean, we took 7 penalties, so obviously we're in the box a lot, and they had lots of rubber on the net. I thought our D really boxed out well. I thought our forwards boxed out well, and we found lots of loose pucks for Peter, but I thought he did a good job playing the puck and stopping the puck and give us an opportunity to be up 1-0 in the series. Yeah, for sure. I mean, if you're standing on their bench, you're thinking you got the puck all the time and it's not going in. But I thought we set ourselves up good going in the third. I thought in the third we were fine. We took too many penalties. And so we never, ever got any traction to play in the offensive zone. And it was kind of like a wave pool. But so we're going to have to do a better job staying out of the box. I thought a few of them were tic-tacky. I don't know if this is a new standard. A few of them were tic-tacky. But in the end, we like to pick up our goalie when he doesn't play good, and we like for the goalie to pick us up when we're not as good. Well, I thought he was unreal. I thought, you know, you look at him and Helmer and Glennie and Millsy and those guys up front, we didn't have enough forwards going, though, to be honest with you. Our D had too much work, but we're going to have to get all hands on deck here tomorrow so we can play better and play the way we're capable of playing. And saying that, we're up, we got one. And so it's a race to 4, and you got to get and start by getting 1. Well, obviously, he's out there on the kill. It's a big, it's a big, big play for us. They get a shorty tonight. We get a shorty. Puts us in a good situation coming down the stretch of the game and gives us the bubble we needed. And, I think it was Carl who walked down the pipe when Yurko missed him late. And Mrazek made an unbelievable save on him. So there was the save we needed to get us the win. Well, I don't know about pressure. I mean, pressure simply means you have a chance. That's all that means. If you had no chance, there'd be no pressure on you whatsoever. So to me, we feel like we got a chance. Did a good job here tonight, found a way to win as a team. Wouldn't have been how I would have drawn it up, but I don't care how you draw it up. You got to win. And so tonight's a good win, and Mrazek stood tall for us, and we can all get better, which is a real positive thing. Well, we got to get quicker. I thought their D did a good job of being up on us, and I didn't think we executed early with the puck, and they got momentum. But I mean, we've played against them lots. They've been up on us, and we've been able to execute. So we got to do a better job of that, and then a little heavier in the offensive zone, spend some more time in there.
Thank you, Mike Babcock, from the podium. Up next, we'll look ahead to Game 2, share some final thoughts on Game 1 when Red Wings Live returns. All right, here's a look at the remainder of the series between these two teams. Game 2 played on Saturday on national TV, a 3 o'clock start there. Games 3 and 4 back in Detroit on Tuesday and Thursday. Games you can see right here on Fox Sports Detroit, beginning with Red Wings Live at 6 o'clock. And
Darren Anazu. We're going to talk about things the Wings can improve on in game two. Certainly getting more shots on net would be one of the top priorities. The minus 32 shot differential tonight, the largest difference in a playoff win in the last 50 years in the National Hockey League.
Now, I'm going to go back to what the coach was talking about, that he didn't have enough forwards going. And I'm going to just surmise that he was talking about Riley Sheahan, Thomas Tatar, and Gus Nyquist. Just two shots for that line as a trio. They fell to the third line in terms of minutes. They have to deliver more.
I mean, the whole team's got to be a lot heavier on the boards. They got to be a lot stronger on the boards. But also, offensively, that's not enough shots. They got to really get another fourth guy into the play. The defenseman got to join the rush. It's hard to get offense against this Tampa Bay team. They take away time and space. You got to join the rush. Got to get four guys in offensively.
Well, ticky-tack or not? Got to stay out of the box.
Yeah, tough to generate offense when you're in the penalty box all night long as well. So you got to clean up that area of the game as well as we look ahead to perhaps taking a 2-0 series lead before the Wings and Lightning return here to Detroit for games 3 and 4. That's about going to do it for us. Once again, the final tonight from Tampa Bay. The Wings take game one by a final of 3-2. We'll leave you with all the best from the game one action in the final take. Darren Elliott and Chris Osgood, I'm Mickey York. Thanks for watching. Good night, kids.